If you're an apprentice rider that seeks to go fast and, you know, like ride like a MotoGP rider on your way to work, well, there was one and only solution for us in India. That is the KTM's RC line of motorcycles. Launched in 2014, they have done seriously very well. They have been on tracks, they have been on roads, they have gone to Leh Ladakh, everywhere. And now, after all these years, we are here at Pune Kartdrome with KTM India for the testing of the all new RC200. So let's go ahead. And after 8 years, we finally have the second generation of the RC line of motorcycles. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Driver's Hub. I'm Kiran. We are at the Pune Kartdrome with KTM India, and today we are going to test the all brand new RC200 on the track.
After keeping it majorly unchanged for 7 years, KTM has finally pushed out the RC200 with its biggest ever update this year. All these changes promise to make it even more friendlier and more accessible while keeping the excitement intact. Most of the changes are related to the unsprung mass.
For the hardware change on the RC200, well, other than the engine, everything else has changed. The main change is there in the unsprung mass. This bike is 3.5 kilos lighter than the previous generation of the RC200. It gets brand new forks from WP Apex that have 10 mm of more travel. So, you know, it just goes down very well. And also there's adjustable rear mono shock. The wheels are lighter by almost half a kilo on each end. And to also to make, you know, that unsprung mass a little bit more balanced, they've also done small bits here and there. The disc rotors are a little bit bigger and now they are directly mounted on the wheels. So you won't be able to swap rims from different bikes from the KTM line of motorcycles, which was possible in the previous generation of the KTM bikes. Also, the major changes, well, three major changes in fact for the RC line of motorcycles. One is the new trellis frame that's there on this bike. It's not the same that's available on the Duke line of motorcycles. It's completely different. Second, the major update which is there is the seats. It's a lot more spacious, it's a lot more narrower, and also for someone short like me, well, it's easier to get both the feet on the ground. Well, you'll still tiptoe, but it's a lot more comfortable. And also if you're getting a girlfriend or friends on the back, well, it's possible because it's also soft, comfortable and spacious. And the last but major update on this bike, that is the fuel tank. The last RC had a fuel tank of almost around 9.5 liters. This one has around 13.5, so that's almost 4 liters more than the previous generation of the RC. And because the handlebars are also a little bit above, well, also go a certain amount of distance on this thanks to the extended range because of the tank. Well, the looks department is something controversial on the internet at least. The keyboard warriors have done their job saying how this does not look good, how they are disappointed, so on and so forth. One thing I can assure you, go to the nearest dealerships, have a look at it in flesh, and it's either it will appeal you or it will grow up on you. Because, well, the looks, other than the headlight, if you cover it up, the silhouette looks like a MotoGP bike. It's completely inspired from the Moto 2 or the Moto 3 line of motorcycles from KTM. Even from the side angle, all the lines from the fairings are cleared out. It's clean, and you can see the function over there that it's made to cut air through and just go straight ahead. And again, the major changes apart from the headlight is the airbox. Other than that, the engine is completely unchanged except for maybe the BS6 norms a little bit here and there. The airbox is 40% bigger. That means, well, you had to ring the throttle completely to gain that power and torque. Well, you won't have to do that anymore. You might have to do that if you're going hard, but when you're cruising around here and there, the torque's available way lower in the RPM range compared to the older line of motorcycles. So that also makes this bike a lot more usable even after being a super sport and, you know, meant for a track or your B roads or etc, so on and so forth. post track, well, the bike is a lot more refined than the previous generation. It's a lot more smooth, and also, well, I won't say it's comfortable completely, but it's a lot more comfortable than the previous generation of the bike. That's mainly thanks to the new seats and the raised up handlebars. So, well, on the track over here, well, it's a short track, so for that it's quite flickable. The power is delivered good, the brakes have good bite, the tires are from MRF, they give sufficient amount of grip. Over here, that's more than enough, but maybe on a bigger racetrack, maybe let's say MMRT or Chennai, if you're pushing it too hard, you might have to change the tire later on. But otherwise, the grip's good, the brakes have decent and not decent, in fact, they have ample amount of bite, and the throttle response is also good. I think the BS6 KTM motorcycles have been more linear as to what they were known for. You know, KTM motorcycles had that brutal raw power that used to just punch in your gut. But over here, it's like, I shall punch in your gut when you're ready for it. It's like that. So if you ease out on the throttle, you can take it off anywhere, you can take any corner, it's a forgiving motorcycle. The chassis is also splendid, you know where the bike is going and you know where the wheels are. So for a small super sport motorcycle in 200cc category, I think KTM has done very well with it. And in fact, with all those changes other than the engine, that is where they have hit the nail spot on, because the engine never needed a change. What needed was the riding dynamics to be changed. So they have changed, they have made the wheels lighter, they have changed the angles of the steering, they have made the handlebars a little bit higher, the seats are comfortable, the foot pegs are adjusted off. So all these small minor things here and there is what has made the experience even more better than the previous generation of the RC200. So well, that's about it from my end from Pune Kartrome. Do let us know what are your opinions on the RC200, and please, if it's anything about the looks, I would request you to go to the showroom, have a look at it, maybe even ride it, and then let us know in the comments down below. Other than that, well, do check out Throttle Store TDH15. We have some sick merch coming up soon, Wiley Run and IBWs next week. So see you guys there, TDH15, check out our merch, all the links in the description. Until then, I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.
Going to take it. And Senna sprints away. Senna is.